Tango traffic, this is Blue S1 picking up Tangle heading back to Reykjavik.
What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another video, and today we're talking about how to achieve that authentic film look for your films. So to achieve this, we're going to use some film grain, film burns, as well as a little bit of sound design to really sell the effect. All the resources that I'm using in today's video will be linked in the description down below for you guys to download. All right, so without further ado, let's hop into Premiere and load in our clip. I'm going to use this shot of the helicopter going over the Brooklyn Bridge, as I think it works well as it's a little bit shaky, as well as it was shot at 24 frames per second with a pretty low shutter speed. So I have all my resources here in my project bin, and I'm just going to drag and drop the film grain on top of my helicopter shot. Once I do this, I'm going to click on my film grain and then go to my effect controls and change the blend mode to overlay. Now, as soon as you do this, you should be able to see the grain on top of your footage. Now, to take this even further, I'm going to adjust the opacity just down to 80% or so, and then I'm going to change the scale up to 105 just to make the grain a little bit more defined. All right, so once we do this, we're going to add in some film burns. And what I think film burns work great for is for transitions. A lot of people just throw these on top of your clips, but if you add these in between your two video layers, I feel like they work great as a method to transition from clip to clip. So what I'm going to do is just drag and drop one of these film burns on top of my timeline. And then I'm going to go to my effect control panel again and change the overlay to screen. Now this will remove all the black areas out of my clip so I can only see the film burn. All right, so lastly, we're gonna add some sound effects. Feel free to get creative with this, but I'm just gonna use a basic film projector sound effect and lay that underneath my clip. And then I'm gonna go to my effects panel and drag and drop on sound reverb. I've been using this effect recently on all my sound effects. I feel like it adds just a little bit more oomph to my final audio mix. So once you add that on, go to the effect controls and press edit, and then change the preset to somewhere not here. All right, now I wanna talk about one last thing that you could add to your video, and that is a film pack from Tropic Color. It comes in 4K, it has a bunch of variations. This is not sponsored whatsoever, but if you guys wanna go check it out, I'll be leaving a link to it in the description down below. Go check it out, it's awesome. I'm using it here in these clips. All right, so there you go. That's how you create the film look, the way I do anyhow, in Premiere Pro. If you guys enjoyed this video, hit that like button down below and leave a comment if you're gonna be using this effect in your next video. But thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed, hit that like button down below, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.